Yeah, so apparently I'm good at pen twirling. That's one of the many useless talents that I have in life. But it was usually because I was bored in class, so I just started twirling a pen, and everybody just started like staring at me, like, "Whoa, he's so cool! How does he twirl that pen that fast?" But that's a completely different story. We are reacting to geography now. Georgia this time, or Sakartvelo, as it's known as in its native language. Sounds pretty cool, but I have no idea how he came to English people as in Georgia. I guess St. George or something, I'm just gonna guess, has something to do with it, and they called it Georgia. So we all know this country for being invaded in 2008 by the Russians and being torn to bits. Basically, they lost South Ossetia and Abkhazia. Well, it wasn't completely torn to bit, but still it lost some land to the Russians. So yeah, that's what I know. And also Stalin is from this country. He's not actually Russian, he's actually Georgian. He's not Joseph Stalin, he's actually Joseph Djigashvili, or whatever his last name is, something like that. So yeah, what else? Also, this country changes its flag like every 2 years, but we'll explain more about that in Flag Friday. So anyway, Paul, what you were searching there? You're watching porn, are you?
All right, let's learn about Georgia. No, Georgia.
Yeah, that's
No,
exactly what I was thinking.
history of Georgia. Famous people from Georgia.
Sakartvelo.
Got it.
Gruzia, as it's called.
It's time to learn geography.
Now!
Hey everyone, I'm your host Barbie. You have no idea how frustrating it is for these people to explain who and where they are from. We have reached our last country in the Caucasus region, and we're gonna have a lot of fun because this place is so incredibly unknown and so incredibly interesting. Welcome to the land of wolves.
Land of wolves? I thought it was a land of white Asian
now,
people.
Now ask a random person on the street where Georgia is on a map. 80% of them won't know, 19.3% of them will point to this, and the remaining 0.7% might get it right. For the
I'm the 0.7%.
99.3% of you normies out there, Georgia is the northernmost Caucasus country located in this quarter slip of land nuzzled between the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea, below eastern Russia, with Turkey and Armenia and Azerbaijan.
That
to
is
the
an
south
unfortunate
end.
Place to
now,
be.
Here's where the geographical dilemma commences.
Russia and
is Georgia in
I mean,
Europe or
Turkey.
Asia? Some will argue that it stands east of Turkey, which is kind of seen as like the gateway to Asia, but culturally it identifies closer with Europe. Ultimately,
Eurasian,
I guess you can
I
conclude
guess.
That it's kind of like both in one. It's a bunch of white people in Asia.
Hey, I said that.
Or Caucasians.
Oh.
Quick side note, the origin
the
of their name, Georgia, is kind of disputed. Some will say that it has to do with Saint George, their patron saint. Others will say that it
I
came
got it
from
right.
the Greeks and their word Georgios, which means tiller of the land, since the land was so fertile. But a lot of scholars might say it comes from
Is
the
it really?
Persian word gurg or gurgen, meaning wolf, hence land of the
What's
wolves.
going on?
I mean,
Wolfpack?
That name does sound
Oh, so
pretty
it's
cool. I mean,
my
if I was a
country.
scholar, I'd probably discredit all the other claims in favor of that one. Nonetheless, Georgians call their own country Sakartvelo, or the land of the Kartvelians, which is another word for Georgians. Now, this is going to be my favorite
that
part
sounds
because
cooler,
you know
Kartvelia.
Incredibly complicated administrative division time. Georgia is a candy shop loaded with territorial anomalies. First of all, if you go to Georgia and look at a map of Georgia that they have drawn out themselves, you'll get something that looks like this. A country divided into what looks like 11 regions and one city, the capital, Tbilisi. Yeah, I know, it looks like Tbilisi.
No, it looks like Tbilisi.
However, it's more like 10-ish regions and two autonomous republics, one of which cuts through parts of four of the regions. These republics are Abkhazia and, be careful what you call the second one, most people outside of Georgia will refer to it as South Ossetia, but in Georgian, it's called Samachablo, or the Skhinvali region. In the simplest way I can put this, these regions came
I call
about
this
through
South
a complicated
Ossetia.
History
Don't
that
kill me.
involved independence from the USSR and then support from Russia after the USSR. Technically, these are at least...
Okay, I'll try to explain hastily how many of these republics came to be. So basically, the Russians wanted to divide and conquer all the peoples surrounding it. So they mixed up everybody ethnically. Like in Abkhazia, there used to be some kind of people known as the Abkhazians, but it's mostly Russians today. Basically, in short, that's how I can explain it. The Russians just kind of moved everybody around, slushed everybody around ethnically, so they focus more on them, and so they have their own internal problems with, and so they can not, focus all their attention towards getting Russia off their backs. And, divide and conquer. Stalin
considered
style.
By most in the international community, autonomous breakaway regions of Georgia that kind of govern themselves but are kind of heavily influenced by Russia as well. To this day, Russia, Nicaragua, Venezuela, and for some reason, Nauru are the only fully sovereign countries that recognize Abkhazia and South Ossetia
they
as independent
Naurans.
Nations. Travel between these two breakaway states is still possible, though. It's just way more difficult for Georgians to enter the regions than it is for Ossetians and Abkhazians to get into Georgia. Phew! So anyway, aside from all that, Georgia is an incredibly vivacious yet rustically refined nook hidden away in the mountains, hard to get to. Like Rivendell. The country is laden with enigmatic castles and centuries-old stony fortresses and archways. like Rivendell, as well as an abundance of monuments and statues with the curiously fascinating, curvy, wispy script written all
like
over. Okay, this is freaking me out. No, but seriously, Georgia is a very rock and stone type of country. They love rocks. The largest cities and airports are, of
come
course,
to Bosnia,
the capital,
my friend.
Tbilisi, Kutaisi, and Batumi. Tbilisi is a bustling city with the stone and mortar Nadi Kara fortress looming above on a hill. Batumi, though, is kind of like the fun city on the Black Sea with a more youthful flair and bold, sharp, dynamic architecture, all adjacent to the famous Batumi stone beaches. I'm telling you, they love stones. Some notable sites would include places like the Gori Fortress with the statues of the eight warriors, or the Kotsky Pillar, a limestone monolith with a single church on top.
How the hell did you get up
there? Climbing. And finally, oh. castles, castles everywhere you go. Notable ones like Rabati, Hinkani, Aspinza, and Ninos Minda, all of which are made of, you guessed it, stones. There's more to this country than just stones, I promise. All right, let's discuss that.
Are the people made out of stone?
Well, as you may have already figured, Georgia is quite mountainous with an expanse of incredibly diverse, conveniently located hills and valleys. The reason why it's so convenient is because the entire country is pretty much nestled between the greater and lesser Caucasus Mountains, which protects it from the blistering cold air masses that pummel southern Russia, yet it also barricades against the hot and dry streams that penetrate from the south. This means that they have overall pretty comfortable weather and just the right amount of rainfall and sunshine. The mighty Kura, or Mtkvari, is the longest river that flows upward and arches south into...
Yeah, that river is missing just a V to sound wrong. And they say Europe has, like, a very fine climate, yet we're freaking boiling up in here. I heard, like, this one person just even died over there. Like, while he was cutting grass, he died from, like, heat stroke. That's how crazy it's getting.
...into the areas through Tbilisi, and the highest mountain and third highest in Europe, if you consider Georgia part of Europe, Mount Sakara, located in the north along
Wait,
the Caucasus.
What's the other one?
Concealed within
Elbrus?
The hills lies the
oh,
Yavkheti
yes,
Volcanic Plateau and the southern Georgia Volcanic Highland. These are some rather unstable geological regions that will produce hot springs, mineral water, and seismic activity. And, of course, caves. So many of them here. You have the still-yet-to-be-completely-explored Meluri Cave in Imereti with waterfalls, the Prometheus Cave that Greeks claim to be the spot where Prometheus was chained to his rock in Greek mythology. Greeks have a history of diaspora in Georgia since like the 7th century. But the most famous cave would probably be the Krubera Cave, found in Abkhazia, otherwise known as the world's deepest cave that goes further than 2,000 meters down. Rapid fire round, you may also want to see the Abasha Waterfalls, Markvili Canyon, Crybaby Mountain because it rains there almost the entire year, the incredibly beautiful Blue
or
Lake in
where
Abkhazia
people go to cry.
Around it for some reason. Speaking of animals, many might say that unofficially the national animal might be the wolf. The Caucasus region has some of the
That's
highest quality of soil in the world in terms of land usage. Georgia has one of the oldest and finest winemaking traditions that go back as far as 300 BC. Otherwise, Georgia has been a hub for mineral mining and petroleum extraction. They share a pipeline that goes through Turkey into Azerbaijan. The national dish would have to be khachpuri, or unofficially
I've
referred to
before.
As Georgian pizza, a decadent soft bread baked with gooey melted cheese, sometimes served with eggs and other ingredients often baked in.
I think Bay I had Lungi. That before.
There's so many different kinds, from the salty, briny, Guni to the weird stringy tanili. They even have a dish where they put cheese inside of cheese. Basically, all you have to know is that when it comes to Georgian cooking, they love cherry plums and tarragon. That's like their go-tos. All right,
What's
enough about food. Let's talk about the people that eat those foods. Georgian cooking, they love cherry plums and tarragon.
Tarragon.
That's like their go-tos.
No fucking idea.
All right, enough about food. Let's talk about the people that eat those foods.
I'll
now,
eat
if
the
you
foods.
Thought pointing out Georgia on a map was difficult, try explaining what a Georgian person...
Looks like they took the English flag now and just put four Templar crosses on it. It is, isn't it?
First of all, one broader term you could use to refer to someone who is ethnically Georgian would be Kartvelian, which encapsulates all the ethno-linguistic groups found in Georgia. If you include Abkhazia and South Ossetia, the country has about 4.8 million people and is currently attempting a population rebound after losing about 1 million people in the past 20 years due to migration. The country is made up of about 87% ethnic
That's
Georgians,
difficult.
Or Kartvelians, 6% Azerbaijani and Azeri, 5% Armenians, and the rest are made up of other groups like Greeks, Russians, and Ossetians. They also use the Georgian lari as their currency. They use the C and F plug outlets, and they drive on the right side of the road. The most distinguishable facet about Georgia, though, would have to be the Georgian language. Like Armenian, it's unlike any other in the world, standing on its own, not derived from any Indo-European or even Asiatic language brand.
What the hell? All the letters look the freaking same to me. I don't know, they all look like U's and W's.
The language is also written in the Georgian script. Technically, they have three alphabets, but they only use one. The alphabet has 33 letters, no F sound, and a ton of strange, almost impossible to pronounce letters. For example,
two, 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 two.
Thank you to those geography peeps. You guys rock. Keep in mind, though, there are other Kartvelian minority languages spoken in Georgia as well, such as Magrelian and Svan in the west and partially in Abkhazia, as well as Laz in the south. Abkhazia and South Ossetia each have their own distinct languages and cultures that contrast with Georgia, although Georgians like to think that Abkhazians are basically just Georgians that speak a different language. The Abkhazian people write in the Cyrillic alphabet, and the Ossetians are actually a Christian...
I was informed that they were just, like, Russians. Mostly ethnic Russians. I gotta check, like, my sources again. Because I read somewhere they're like, in Abkhazia is just Russians. Maybe I'm wrong.
Iranian-based ethnic group that inhabited the area. Keep in mind, I said Iranian, not Persian. Not all Iranians are Persians. Just keep that in mind. Now, we don't really have time to explain the complete history, but basically, all you have to know is that in the 3rd century BC, some dude named King Parnavaz of Kartli united all the Kartvelian-speaking tribes in the Caucasus area, hence creating what was essentially the first proto-Georgian nation. From there, you had Romans, Persians, Arabs, Turks, Golden Age, where they had women under the title of king, Mongols, Ottomans, Russians, and finally back to Georgia. Done! The funny thing is, even after 2 millennia of usurping empires, Georgia still maintained and held on to their own distinct identity, refusing to completely assimilate to any outside system. Christianity is the dominant religion, as about 84% of the population adheres to the Eastern Orthodox faith, 10% mostly being Muslim from the Azerbaijani population, and the remainder are mostly Armenian Apostolic or Roman Catholic. Christianity is kind of like a big deal here. Georgia became one of
Russia
the first countries
had a hand
in the world
in
to
all
adopt
this.
Christianity, and as tradition holds, Jesus' disciple Andrew preached the gospel into ancient Scythia, which included the regions that Georgia lies in today. Also, a lady named Saint Nino converted the entire country. Culture-wise, Georgia is kind of strange because it's not quite European and it's not quite Asian. It's its own thing. Georgian polyphonic singing is actually filed under UNESCO's Intangible Heritage List. Mam shordka igone na ubari. Mam shordka igone na ubari. All Georgians will tell you that
nice.
Georgian
I'd give them
$5
now
if I they are proud
could.
Of fast, difficult, dynamic, and bold.
For the good music,
weeping
not,
and pointing. Georgians are also known for being really into strength sports, even women. They love wrestling and weightlifting and judo.
So I don't mess with
well
them, okay.
The Constantine Yanashia reaching some
Georgia
of the highest
is the best
ranks in
country
world's
in the
strongest
world.
Man competition. Speaking of which, the most notable Georgian
oh, yeah,
in the world
guy
ever
is.
Seen, although they might not be proud of it, would probably be Joseph Stalin. Although, to be fair, he did spend a lot of his time in Russia being a Russian dictator, so... Yeah. Hospitality is a huge deal out here. As the saying goes in Georgia, a guest is a gift from God. And granted, no matter who you are, they'll pretty much just treat you to some khachpuri. And that's kind of how they are with their diplomacy.
Seems nice.
Russia. Let's explain.
What was that? I think I heard him say Russia.
In the simplest way I can put this, Georgia is like the Christian country with the most Muslim friends. It's weird because everything is like a high school drama with their neighbors. They get along well with Azerbaijan and Turkey. Trade and travel has been open for centuries. However, the memory of the Ottoman times still lingers ever so slightly. So they keep things at a flat platonic
cordial. Come on, they're gone. They're not coming back.
Armenia kind of used to be their best friend, but then too many things happened
Maybe.
And they kind of decided not to hang out as much. It first started in the 6th century with the Council of Chalcedon, in which they split over secondary Christian doctrine issues. Armenia became Apostolic Orthodox, similar to the Coptic Syriac Ethiopian branches, whereas Georgia stayed Eastern Orthodox, like the Greeks, Serbians, and Russians, and most of the other Eastern European states. Also, keep in mind, Armenia
okay, so
favored Russia after all that drama with Abkhazia and South Ossetia, so that kind of split the divide a little bit more. Their best friends, though, would probably be the Ukraine and the Balkan countries, like Latvia and Lithuania and Estonia,
Balkan?
Even though Estonia is kind of, like, too busy.
You mean Baltic? Did you say Balkan or Baltic there?
Would probably be the Ukraine and the Balkan countries, like
yeah,
Latvia and Lithuania and Estonia, even though Estonia is kind of, like, too
I'm
busy
pretty sure
shutting it up
difference.
With Finland. All these countries have had the same scenario of dealing with some kind of form of aggression with Russia and, in a sense, bond over the shared calamity. However, there's a strange twist, because even though you would think Georgia's worst nightmare would be Russia, they kind of secretly still kind of a little bit maybe still have a soft spot for them. Each country has family of their own residing in each side and loves to visit each other. Even though politically it looks bad, the general citizens of each country still love each other and look forward to each encounter. Huh, isn't it funny how the general populace of a country is not always directly represented by their government? Shocking. In conclusion, Georgia is an elaborately hidden, rustic yet modernized medieval domain locked away in the secret hidden mountains, caught between two worlds that it refuses to identify with its own vibrant heritage that has stood the test of time on its own, especially that melted cheese bread part. Stay tuned, the big guy, Germany, is coming up next.
Deutschland. Okay, we're gonna get to I'm gonna get to Deutschland right after this. But first, flag. How many flags
right,
do they have? Come
peeps,
on.
Let's do this. Georgia, not Georgia. Georgia, not Georgia. Georgia, not Georgia. Got it? Great. All right.
I like the name Kartvelia. Anybody here for Kartvelia? Sounds cool.
Saakatvelo, what a nice and pleasant fellow. Georgia is one of those countries where you can kind of tell that they took history kind of very seriously when it came to developing their national symbols. First of all, the flag of Georgia is sometimes called the five cross flag because it kind of has five crosses on it. Made up of a white banner with the big red St. George cross. Keep in mind, this is the same saint that the flag of England is derived from, as St. George is considered to be the patron saint of the country. Four other small red crosses occupy each quadrant that the big cross divides and are said by many to represent the five holy wounds of Christ. Now keep in mind, this flag was actually adopted in 2004. However, it was derived from the former Georgian Kingdom flag, which enjoyed about five centuries of dominance in the Caucasus region. Otherwise, Georgia went through a series of flag switches with monarchs changing things up every so often. Flags. Like David the Builder with his unicorn and Tamar with her golden age.
Rebellion.
Then the Russians came and this happened. Then after independence, they used this flag, but a lot of people didn't like it because it was kind of like the exact same flag that the Russians gave them back in 1918. So then they switched it up and voila, today's flag was born.
Now, they also had like a three variants,
one complicated,
color flag.
One simple. We're going to cover the complicated one. Basically, the center blazon contains a red shield with an image of St. George riding a horse, trampling a dragon as St. George stabs the dragon with a spear. Fun little side note for a future episode. If you zoom in really close, you'll notice that this is the exact same image that's portrayed on the small cross in the corner of the Maltese flag. Okay, moving on. Both sides of the shield are supported by golden lions with a royal crown of Georgia on the top and a silver banner below written in the modern Mkhedruli Georgian script reading Zala Ertobashia, meaning strength is unity. Now keep in mind, of course, during the years they switched up their coat of arms many times as well. Of course, during the Soviet years you could find the hammer and sickle images all over, and at one point the royal house had a real complicated coat of arms that had things like a harp, a tunic of Jesus, an orb, and all these curtains and angels with swords, but we're not gonna get into that. Essentially what it comes down to is Georgia uses the St. George cross, which makes things easy. But then England kind of got in on that, so they just added more crosses. Thanks for watching. This has been Flag Friday.
You've not just enough crosses.
Stick.
Okay, big boy, Germany coming up next. I'm excited for the next one because it is one of the countries that defines the world even to this day. So stay tuned. Germany coming up next. Take care.